Okay, what is up, guys? We are back on Pokemon Showdown. It's still the same day that I recorded episode 2 for my road to top 10. I'm a bit calmed down now. We will just get a game with this Specs Prime Arena squad I built today. I played one game in my Showdown Live number 44, I think, or was it 45, that I already uploaded earlier. And so you guys already noticed, team, someone was interrupting me down the back, so that was why I was speaking a bit. That was a bit confused. So this guy is a really cool team, has a Mega Beedrill. What did I want to say? Yeah, I wanted to record another episode because the next days I will record SPL and I'm not going to be able to record to ladder. So potential Beedrill lead, potential Mammoth One lead here. So what is good versus these two? Yeah, Mammoth One is a big threat, but I think I can leave with Tangrowth because I'm max defense. Yeah, if he leaves Beedrill, that's really, 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 really bad. But I should be able to get up a Sleep Powder here. Since I'm max defense. Yeah, I thought he would just go for U-turn up. I even have a Poison Jab because I'm like max defense, like I said. And I hope I can connect here with my Sleep Powder. Tangrowth was just a decent lead as we missed our Sleep Powder turn 1. Got a lost Pokemon. I think I want to go Zapdos here in case he goes Coco on a potential Sleep Powder. He goes for Spikes, which I can just defog away. Mamoswine is in, the threat is here, the threat is now. Like, I have no good resist to Mamoswine. I didn't think about Mamoswine when I built this team. Of course I have to face a Mamoswine now. I don't really need my Zapdos that much. I can roost up later on the... Okay, that did absolutely nothing. Okay, I'm so lucky and bad. He gets a crit, but the burn is way more. The burn matters so much more. Like, that sucks. Oh, let me fix this real quick so it looks a bit better. Okay. Since I'm faster, I can beat this 1v1. Like, Earthquake doesn't do much, I can defog on this always. Mamoswine is the biggest threat to my team and I just hexed it. I have HPS on my Tangrowth to beat Zygarde. Maybe I should go into detail with my team. I built this really fast, so it might have some flaws. We have AV Majirna and Volt Switch on Zapdos and on AV Majirna to bring in Specs Primarina. We have Max Speed Modest. And this is for Mega Morwile, the Tangrowth. Yeah, I can just roost spam. Like, I don't even have to go for heat wave. The burn just builds them down because I'm so lucky. Like, Mamoswine is nothing you see high ladder on, honestly. I mean, it's still good high ladder, but you just don't see it that much. I can just go to my Tangrowth here. So that's nothing that comes to mind when I team build a Mamoswine. So I can just fire off a knockoff here in case he wants to go Tapu Koko. Giga Drain on knockoff. I feel like knockoff is fine. He shouldn't stay in anyway. If his helmet, that's a bit annoying, but he's left over, so I feel like always just going Zapdos and this is fine. I don't see how I can lose this now that I hexed his Mamoswine. I'm in a really good position. Tapu Koko is kind of a threat to this team. My best answer to this Tapu Koko is my Solvus Majirna. Which will get whittled down with it in time. So I would like to have a wish pass on this team, but Alamola didn't fit on the team and I didn't want to go too defensive. Like, if I go Alamola or Primarina, that just doesn't work out. I need some offensive pressure. He makes a double into Beedrill, which is a nice play, but it doesn't really do anything because I can just... I can go to Magearna here because he's either U-turning or poison jabbing. Yes, and if he wants to drill run, that's fine. I think I can go to Zapdos here, because he's like U-turning or drill running. I can even go to Landers, honestly. Okay, yeah, goes for drill run and knocking. I can just go for Heat Wave or Volt Switch here. Yeah, Heat Wave is fine. So he goes for U-turn. Yeah. I lost my train of thought. Yeah, I wanted to say I use Helicon almost every team, but that's just how I build at the moment. Is it a good Zard X, Zard Y check, and War Corona, which my teams are always weak to. But Spring Marina is so cool, I hope it can do some work. So yeah, Tapu Koko is annoying to deal with. But can I even switch and it is? Yeah, Magearna. I mean, I can go to Tangrowth here, I think. I need my Tangrowth for the... Okay, that does a shitload. I don't know if that's Zaplate. I don't think it's Specs. Because I know Tangrowth has really bad speed there, so the Voltron Core is coming here. The Voltron Core is a bit annoying. Yeah, we'll just go Magearna. If he goes for Drone, he goes for Drone. Probably shouldn't have made this play, because then this is my best type of Coco check. But yeah, thankfully Tangrowth has a Regenerator, so... Like, he can double back to Beedrill here. But I'm just gonna stay in, it's too risky. He goes for Outrage, gets a crit, which is a bit annoying, but this is probably Bandit, so... I should Kalk. If he's Bandit. Used 1000 arrows and 14% to my Tangrowth. So I can just Kalk real quick if that's Bandit damage. And then I can find out if it's Bandit, I can just go into Primarina here. Basically get a free kill. My net is a bit laggy. I'm pretty sure I will just play like if he's Bandit, because 15% seems a lot to my Tangrowth. So this is basically a free Psychic Key in case he goes to Toxapex. Which he does. And we will blow his Toxapex away. So now he's gonna go to Skarmory. I can double here to my Zapdos. If he goes for Baneful Bunker, yeah, that's fine. If he goes for Mamoswine. Since I got lucky and burned this, I don't have to worry about anything. I can just go for Heat Wave. Even though this was a bad play, I should've just spammed Default. I should've just spammed Roost. Oh, Vault Switch. That was a really bad play. Now I get Rocks Up. I can defog on this though, because the first turn 1000 arrows is not super effective on my Zapdos. So yeah, I had no reason not to defog there. I need Rocks Off. I get where he's coming from with this play. But yeah, I'm gonna just Heat Wave in case he Poison Jab so I get good damage. Is he Drillon's over predicting there? He thought I would go into Magearna. And can just Volt Switch now. So he goes for Poison Jab, doesn't get the poison. And I will just send up my Scarf and the Heligo. I can go to my Tangrowth if you don't get Regenerator, but I feel like Scarf and Heligo is nice to keep out the type of Coco. So yeah, I will just think positive. I hope we can just win the games in this one as Skarmory comes out. I have no reason to risk a Sunder here, so I'm just gonna go Zapdos. If he gets Spikes up, I just defog. That's completely fine. I've already recorded 3 videos today. My voice is a bit kind of at the end. I kind of wouldn't miss with this Landris if he didn't have Whirlwind. But I don't see reason not to go just back to Zapdos. I don't think it matters how I play this endgame. Like, I could have SD'd that and killed him with the Z-move, potentially. Just weakened him a lot, but by doing this I get my Zapdos back to a good amount of health, which is also nice. I can just go into Tangrowth on the Zygarde. Like, if he crits me again with Outrage, I might almost die. But yeah, if he goes for Outrage, Primarina just gets a free kill. So I don't really agree with that play. Like, I can just go for Hydro Pump here. That should do a shitload to everything. I just have to hit this. We hit, nice. I mean, this game would have been potentially close if I didn't luck out versus the Mamoswine. I hope I don't face another Mamoswine. Okay, this guy's a threatening team. Let me check his rank. copy bands are. He thought he didn't warn ya. And he met the room hidden, so he probably, maybe he knows my YouTube. Zapdos is nice in this matchup, but if he's banned out, that's bad. I kind of want to just lead off with Primarina here. He should be Rock's Landorus, so if he leads with Landorus, Primarina pretty much gets the free. Yeah, pretty much. I just click HP Fire here. This is an unnecessary aggressive play. Probably Moonblasting is the better play in case he goes Tapu Fini. If he goes Fini though, I have some. Like Zapdos is a fine switch, and if he goes Fini. I just want HP Fire. Yeah. I knew he would make this play, and I should have just Moonblasted there. I don't know, this guy probably knows my YouTube and knows I play like that. So it just goes up to see if he doubles the Cheetah. He doubles the Volcarona, that's fine. We just Volt Switch, like. Don't think we lose anything from vaulting. If he doubles to Landorus, if he Quiver Dances, that's fine. I just go into my Heligo. And I'm forced to click Power Gem. I cannot play around with this. Like, so let's think about this. There's no way he sacks his Volcarona, so I can make an aggressive play here. But I shouldn't play around with this. If he goes to Ferrothorn, I can always defog, so let's just go for, yeah, exactly. I almost went for a HP Fire there for no actual reason. And I would have gotten so fucking mad. I actually would have gotten so mad. I'm so glad that I didn't make the aggressive play and he just forfeits. Oh god, I'm so glad. Okay, we can get another one. I will keep this episode a bit shorter. I just hope I can win one or two more games and end it. So this guy's an interesting team, Sticky Web. My only member that relies on not having Sticky Webs up is Money Heligo. But yeah, I can defog on some things. I can defog on Skarmory and on on Pinsir. Zapdos is really nice in this match. Superior is a threat, a little bit of a threat, but I can deal with it. Nidoking is also a threat. Nidoking is looking like a huge menace. Oh god, this is gonna be hard to deal with. So I'm thinking I can just lead off with my Magearna and a Volt Switch out to break the Sash from the Galvantula, and then I can revenge him with Scarf Nihiligo, but then he could go Nidoking, so let me think this through. If he doesn't have HPIs, I can just leave with Landorus and set up on his Galvantula and just 6-0 him. Or not 6-0, but weaken his team. I'm not sure how much Zapdos actually takes from Galvantula's. Yeah, but he's not Life Orb. They don't run Life Orb. Sanado's 54 of his Life Orb, but they don't run Life Orb. They run Sash, so. Yeah, I can actually do with Zapdos and just keep defogging on his. Okay, never mind. Yeah, so I'm gonna just Volt Switch here or Heat Wave. I don't think I'll lose anything from Volt Switching. If he goes hard into Nidoking. If he goes hard into Nidoking, that's really. Like, I need this healthy for the Pinsir. So I don't want to stay in and take a plus 2 hit after he leaves Storms. Like, but if he goes hard Nidoking here, I'm in such a bad position. So he goes for Substitute. So I should have just gone for Heat Wave. I wish I had Boom Blast. I feel like Magearna's Volt Switch should break the Substitute. So this way I don't take damage on everything else and just got the slow Volt Switch out. And Magearna should eat anything up. Glare would be annoying. But yeah, he just has Leaf Storm. We eat that for breakfast. I really hope this breaks the sub as it does. And I'm going to Heligo here. The problem with this is he gets a free switch into Nidoking. And I'm forced to Sludgerave here. I want to double switch on a Nidoking, but yeah, these players on the low ladder, yeah, I would have doubled there and would have gotten mad again. Like, what do I even double to beat Nidoking? I don't know why he went into Galvantula. Like, this guy is just giving me free beast boosts. Cause now if you switch out, like, this is gonna hurt even. Like, okay, he has a Skarmory which is immune. Yeah, I don't know why he'll just let the Sash get broken. goes Zapdos here. He should predict this, but he doesn't have anything that pressures Zapdos besides the Nidoking with life or with Ice Beam. So he just gives me the freest defog I've ever seen, unless he's max speed Jolly, which he's not. So just all his hazards are gone, all his hard work. Yeah, this guy's not playing optimal. We gotta get one more after this. Hopefully that will not be our downfall, as he's probably gonna go for Ice Beam. So I'm gonna go Nidoking doesn't kill him. I don't know how to pivot around this. Nidoking is a really, really big threat to this type of balance I'm running, or bulky offense, however you want to call it. Like, I still need Zapdos for the Pinsir. For Hitmonlee, I have Tangrowth, so. Magearna is really. I guess I have to sack something. Yeah, I guess it's gonna be Magearna. Magearna might live an Ice Beam into Earth Power. Since it's so bulky, and I can just go for Flash Gun, get good damage. I hope I live an Earth Power. I live one, Magearna the God. So we get some damage and then Nidoking. And we're just gonna sack this off. Ice Beam's there in case I try to pivot. I don't think Scarf Nidigo kills Nidoking from 34. Poison does 26 to 31. So no, we don't kill him. So I think I have to go to Zapdos, that's my only play, and go for Heat Wave. If I miss, I just lose the game, because Primarina dies to Sludge Drive, I'm pretty sure. I mean, I can calc it, but I don't want any bulk on my Primarina, so that's bad. If I was max HP, I could, actually, even if I was max HP, I would die. It's a roll in his favor. This dies to Sludge Wave. Then this dies to Ice. Yeah, I have to go. This is the reason I should run more speed on my Landorus, but the bulky spread is necessary to set up on Venusaur, because this team is so weak to Venusaur. The only way to beat it is Psychic mid with Primarina. If I miss this Heat Wave, I just lose. Thankfully we hit. Pinsir's a threat, but we still have Scarf and Heligo, so we're good. Yeah, we're just facing these wall breaking threats like Nidoking and Mamoswine on the low ladder. There's no reason to go hard in Heligo and risk getting T-Bolt Thunder Peril. I mean, I can roost here in case he makes. Okay, I don't know why you would ever go for that play, so. Don't I just defog spam? I have to defog spam. I have to keep the rocks. Also, my Heligo outspeeds. I could have roosted there, but. This defogging is fine. My Nidoking outspeeds this Pinsir if I keep the webs off. If he crits me or he kills me with a roll, I think I just Power Gem sweep him. Oh, his Skarmory is at full. But yeah, I just click Power Gem here to keep out the Nidoking. Yeah, I gotta change this team maybe. Nidoking is such a threat to this team, good god. I can click HP Fire, but Power Gem should be fine. Yeah, he went hard Skarmory, which was not the play, because this gets too KO'd. He can go on the Hitmonlee, but he didn't switch. I don't know why he didn't switch. Yeah, Nidoking should win this, just get more damage on the Hitmonlee. So we just go hard Tangrowth on this. Really some tough matchups, like... I mean, as in the Nidoking was such a threat, the rest of the team I could deal with somewhat okay. But yeah, that off power might have been a roll on the Magearna. So looking back at it, I shouldn't have let my Magearna take the Leaf Storm earlier. I'ma just knock out Giga. I feel like Gigaing is fine. I thought he would go to Galvantula, sleep fodder there. I guess I can sleep powder now. He just goes hard pincer, but he doesn't dodge, so this is just a free Nidoking. Okay, just forfeits. Okay, we will grab one more. Everything has been going well so far. Let's hope it stays like that. Let me check this guy's rank. So Lucario is cool. Thankfully we have the max defense Changos to check that. The Rotom Wash is a bit annoying. Okay, this guy doesn't have the best win-loss ratio, but that's not... Focus on that. Tapu Koko is kind of a threat, yeah. Let me close the lobby chat, it's actually annoying. Landorus can kill Rotom after a bit prior damage. I'm thinking he's rocks Pharaoh Scarf Jump, or if he's hazard stacking, he's rocks Jump. But he has a defogger, so hazard stacking doesn't make much sense. I wanna leave with Primarina. But if he leaves with his electric types, it's gonna be bad. Nah, Primarina is not this good this matchup. It's only good versus the to catch the Pharaoh with HP Fire and to hit this with Moonblast. To come in on this and click HP Fire breaking the Pharaoh. So I'm gonna keep my eyes open for that. I feel like Zapdos. Tangrowth is a really good lead in this matchup. Hopefully he doesn't lead with Pharaoh Sound as he does. So this is a bit annoying. I can always go to Zapdos and defog on this. Because I don't want hazards on my side of the field. That's just how I play Zapdos. If he had a bishop, I would have had to play it different. But he doesn't have a bishop or anything with Defiant. So I can just defog all the time. If he has knockoff, it's a bit annoying. Rotomwash, yes, you can blow with me, but I'ma just vault out. I should be faster, and then like if my Tangrowth gets Will-O-Wisp, I don't think it's the end of the world. And now he has a free vault switch into Pharaoh Thorn, so I'ma click knockoff, predicting that if I had HP Fire, I would click HP Fire here, but I don't have it. If he goes Lucario, this guy's wild. Like he gets a 3+1 if he gets Lucario, but that's, I don't think that's the play. But if he's wild, he could make that play. Like, you never go Lucario here on a potential HP Fire. Like, I either go for Giga Drain Leaf Storm or for Knock Off here or HP Fire. That's my options. Those are my options. He could be Z-Move Coco. Okay, he's Leftovers Coco, which he might be. Is he Subcon Mind? So I'm not staying in here. Coco worked for him out, I guess it couldn't be put to sleep, but Tangrowth was fine. But yeah, in case I have HP Fire, I get the Coco play. I was burnt there, so even Earthquake wouldn't have done that much. Yeah, I'll just go to my Majurna. U-turn is a good play, I guess. Because Landorus would have blocked a Volt Switch. I could have gone Landorus there, because I'm a bulky spread. Max HP, some speed dev. I don't have HP Fire on this, which is a bit annoying. I'ma just vault on this, like hard into Zapdos, just back into Zapdos. Always keep rocks off. This game is a bit annoying, might take a bit longer. But yeah, I just always keep the rocks off. With my pressure ability, I have more defog PP than he has rocks. And he's probably gonna vault here. I could make a really unnecessary play and go hard into my Landris on the Volt Switch and pivot from there, but I'ma just go Tangrowth. Like, if he Volt Switches, he Volt Switches. What, like, I don't care. Like, that's fine. I don't take any damage because I have Regenerator. Like, I knew he Volt Switched there. I could have pivoted from Landris and Tangrowth on the Hydro Pump. Or on the next Will-O-Wisp. And then I could have fired off, like, a Giga Drain or HP Ice on knockoff. Probably in Giga Drain. So Lucario comes out, which thankfully the electric terrain ends, so I can attempt to put this to sleep. This is like my, if he's Lumberry, this is really bad. He's not Lumberry, so I think Landorus is the play. Is it Landorus or Zapdos? I feel like Zapdos is better in case he has Ice Punch, because Landorus, even though it gets off the Intimidate, I'ma just Volt Switch here, because he should be faster, right? Volt Switch just to bring him range, break a potential Sash, should bring him range from HP Fire from when the Heligo, I should cut this. Like, I'm not trying to like throw more points out the window like I did in my last life. Like, Discharge is 49 to 48, so Volt Switch should do around 40-ish. And how much does Nihiligo do? HP Fire I should kill after Volt Switch. So he goes with Rotom, which gives me a switch into Nihiligo. I want to make an aggressive play on HP Fire here, but is it worth it? It is not worth it. I'm just gonna Power Jam. I had, like, I almost wanted to say, like, I wanted to say in the chat that I wanted to click HP Fire, but I don't want to reveal yet that I have HP Fire. I could click it later on. Like, I don't have to play aggressive for no reason. Like, I can just go for to the Zapdos and default every time. Like, if you do this play, that's completely fine. I just get a free heat wave. And he just let his frozen take the huge chunk. Yeah, this guy wasn't playing optimal. Just default on this. And I'm gonna end it after this match. Because I want to end off on a positive note. Today's like a kind of stressful day. Like, besides from that one life where I didn't play too well and get super mad. I also got mad because some other stuff came up. Some IRL stuff, I guess. I mean, it was nothing too bad. Like, I'm doing fine, but it was... I had to do some work and it was annoying. So, this is either Scarf or Zemoth with ST. He's already Lucario with ST, this should be Scarf, and it's the Coco is the Scarfer. He could be mixed, but Landris should be fine. Landris... Okay, like, I can SD on this. I can also just go to Zapdos just to keep Vox off. And I can Volt Switch here. Because he's not gonna sack his Ferrothorn. If I SD there with my Landris, would have been nice, I guess. Get the Volt Switch on the Coco, get a nice momentum going. I can go to Nihiligo here and click Sludge Wave. Like, I really don't care if he brings in his Ferrothorn. I just don't want to overpredict for no reason. Like, I could have clicked HP Fire the last time his Ferrothorn came out with my Nihiligo, and I could have done it this time. But it's not the high ladder. I don't feel like I have to take those risks. Like, he's not making any super crazy plays. I still feel like Volt Switching here is fine. Like, he might stay in. I guess he can stay in this time. Yeah, this game is a bit long, this last game. But yeah, he keeps making the Coco play, so I'm glad that I Volt Switched. I'm gonna just make the Magearna play this time. No, I'll make the Nihiligo play again. And I'm gonna just Sludge Wave again. Like, I really don't care that you have a Ferrothorn. Like, I could care less. I don't have to predict this game. Like, the way he is playing. If he would play more aggressive, I might have to adapt. But at the moment, he's not making any crazy plays, so I can just play safe. Just bring my Landris in. Even if he's mixed jump or bulky Landris, I can take a Draco plus another Draco. And if he goes into Pharaoh, I can just go into my Zapdos. Like, this doesn't do anything. Yeah, you leash it. Congratulations. I'm gonna just roost this time. Actually, I might heat wave this time because he keeps going Coco. I guess vaulting there would have been nice as he dodges the heat wave. Which is annoying, which is definitely annoying. I'm kind of forced to go into my Magearna here. Yeah, that was a bit annoying. Goes for HPS, trying to catch my Landris, and I'm just gonna go for like Volt Switch here. Man's went for U-turn. Yeah, he passed pay card PM'd. Okay, yeah, he wants to pass me team that got him to rank one. Yeah, I actually don't mind that. That's fine. You can pass me your team, dude. I was thinking about Aura Sphere there, but I actually have no reason to like make any plays. So yeah, I can just Heatwave here. If this Coco didn't dodge the last Heatwave, he might die to this. So he just goes Rotom, which I get a crit. That doesn't matter. This dies to Volt Switch, I'm pretty sure. And I just go into my Nihiligo here, or what do I go to? So yeah, Volt Switch kills. I wanna go Primarina here, cause Primarina is really nice actually. Too bad the Electric Terrain. The Electric Terrain just goes back up because it ended. Like, it just goes back up if he goes Coco, is what I meant to say. This is a nice lure because if he goes Ferrothorn, I can just bop him with a Specs HP before I had kills easily from this range, unless he's max to death. Like, I've seen the Ferrothorn drop from full HP, like, I don't know if he's gonna go to Tapu Fini now, that's a good play. But I think he doesn't know about the HP fire attack. I mean, it's not really attack, they all run this, all the Primarinas run this. And yeah, his first one just drops and this game should be over. Hope you guys all enjoyed, been thankfully I did better in this one. I mean, in the last one I was also 5-0 and then I started losing. The games were fast, I wanted to make it a longer episode. I feel like I could go Landorus, because I never went Landorus before on the Coco, so I don't think he's going to HP Ice. Yeah, he makes a T-Ball play, and he had enough, he said, I'm out. He said, yeah, he disconnected, it says. So I'm going to just make the Magena hit play here, because in case he tries to HP Ice. I mean, I can just Earthquake here, I don't need health on my Landorus. Actually, yeah, health on my Landorus is nice for the Garchomp, so just in case he comes back, I'll make the Magena play. Because if he wants to, like, U-turn, that's completely fine. Because if he goes Garchomp, I just go back to Landorus. His Lucario is asleep, so that's not a threat. His this game is over. Yeah, higher ladder star is common. But yeah, it's nice if he passes the team. Yeah, higher ladder is gonna be a pain, so this would be nice that he has a team that beats Stall. So I will gladly use that and take that. So yeah, this guy just times out, you guys can see it. Yeah, I will gladly leave my team in the description for you guys. This team is pretty cool, it needs some more testing. But like, stuff like Nidoking and Mamoswine is not really common on the ladder, so you should be fine. The Storm matchup is rough. This is the reason I have this Landorus on the team. It's just rocks with SD. Same spread that I used in my other team. This gets forward KO'd. Like Venusaur, if you are at full, Venusaur forward KO's you. Like, it has like a 10% chance to 3 KO you or something. So it's a roll in your favor. So you can SD up like 2 or 3 times on Venusaur. Now, you can SD on Venusaur and then you can like fire off Earthquakes, you don't have to SD twice. But in case you really need multiple SDs, you can even get multiple SDs on Venusaur. I like the spread a lot. It's element. You guys see it in the description. Yeah, there are other threats to this team. Zard X is a threat, but you just, if you face a Zard X, you just play it that way. I mean, this has Stone Edge, this Landorus, so you're fine versus Zard X, I guess. Because like some Landorus, they only run HP, Ice, U-turn, and Earthquake and Rocks, right? So Zard X sets up on them if they stay regular form. So you have to basically play it the way that you switch out to something, the force starts to Mega Evolve, and then you go back to your Lando. So basically I have to sack him on, kind of, or let Landorus take a really huge hit. I mean, this Landorus is not max defense, it's not the best Zard counter, but it somewhat checks it, and you have Scarf and the Heligo to come in and revenge. So yeah, Zard X should be a bit threatening, but not the end of the world. And there's a reason I run Zapdos, and this is because I wanted to like be prepared for stuff like, what's it called? Z-Move Gyarados and Volt Switch, just to bring in Primarina, like this double Volt Switch. U-turn on this would be nice, but I don't think I had space. So thank you guys for watching. As per usual, I was running at the end. Yeah, Pickett joined again there. He thought I would get another game. But yeah, I want to record SPL. I think it's in 1 hour and 30 minutes. But I still want to do some other stuff and eat, etc. PP. Yeah, this team should be really fun to use. But yeah, if you guys ever like see some weakness and you like improve the team and it works out better for yourself, you guys can like hit me up. That would be really cool if you like changed anything on my team and like explained to me why you did it and if it's been working out well to you, that'd be really cool. So yeah, I've been running for way too long. I'm Doc, which I'm signing out. Thanks for watching. Peace, friends.